Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, there's no need to introduce Mies van der Rohe here. He was a great architect with not so great social and husband skills. But the story is not just about Mies. We also met Lilly Reich in her apartment in 1928 on the Potsdamer Platz in Berlin. She was a woman with lots of talent and a strong taste of design for her age. She went through school, a tough school in Vienna, by Josef Hoffmann's workshops. Her character was as strict, as well-organized as a smart person could be. Before she met him, she was already vice president of the German Werkbund and had her own design office. She was so charming that even Mies couldn't resist her. This first scene took place in 1928 on the Potsdamer Platz in Lilly's apartment. She was preparing for sleep as nothing happened.
Hello, Lilly Reich is here.
Lilly, dear, amazing news.
Oh, Mies, it's you.
I need to talk to you personally.
Yeah,
are you sleeping?
No, not at all. I'm always glad to see you.
I will be in touch with you.
See you. Oh, Mies.
Darling. I just talked to him Monday.
And you talked to each other since Giulio. If you were Michelangelo, he would be your medici. You're a talented, he's powerful. You really woke me up for this.
You just don't understand. Hermann just talked to Freiherr von Schmitter.
And?
The director of IG Farben.
Okay.
And they were looking for an architect to design Barcelona Pavilion, I think, really. A German pavilion in Barcelona, yes. And they want me,
you,
us, to participate.
That's wonderful.
Bring the champagne, we need to celebrate.
No, not today. We have prepared a catalog for the upcoming exhibition, and your daughter's birthday is approaching next week.
We'll remember.
This is the end of the first scene. We are now in the offices of the Valerya, where Lilly and Mies are working each other on the Great Pavilion of Barcelona.
What about something like this?
Oh, it looks really nice. I really like it. I like this simplicity floor plan that you did here. But are you sure about those walls here? I would delete them on your place. And maybe to shift this one of them. But here. Or there. Have you thought about texture?
I don't know. We should embrace the simplicity of the floor plan as you did here, and maybe to add some grand texture with really precious stuff.
I know. We can use marble or even Tridentine. I just remembered my father's restored Viking cathedral. This stone could be so elegant.
Perfect. It sounds perfect. Have you thought about interior design, about furnishing? It would be like we can treat them as exhibition space we did for the last time. After all, it's all scenography, theatrical, and it's temporary.
I don't know.
I know. We can do like the metal tube chairs that we did.
Isn't it too simple?
No, listen, it's not too simple. We can combine simple structure with some grand material. For example, leather and chrome that shines. After all, we have that opportunity to represent Werkbund to the rest of the world. We cannot miss that.
Okay. I think I got it. Like this? Or like this?
The second scene ends. and we are now in Barcelona. It's May 20th of 1929, and the Great Pavilion has its grand opening. Here are some visitors' reactions.
Ah, oh, that's so amazing! The architect Mies outdid himself.
Yes, indeed. I actually heard that he collaborated with an architect also. No, but I don't understand. I don't remember the name.